Greeting, my dear brothers and sisters. Praise the holy name of the Lord. It is beautiful and wonderful to come to your beautiful homes and your churches. And thank you for having us. We love you guys. We love you guys. We love you guys. And we praise the holy name of the Lord today. Again, I'm going to continue our journey about the miracles, you know, what the Lord is really doing in our life. Okay, I hope last week you guys enjoy the great signs and wonders. The Lord has really marvelously, He did great signs and wonders, and you know, it continues. So, you know, I want you guys to really call your friends. You're tuned into this Trinity, Timidity, and Temerity program, and you know, please call your friends, jot down everything that God is going to give you, the great nuggets. And I let my sister Abina pray for all of us. God bless everyone. Abina.
Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. You're the King of all the kings. You're the Lord of all the lords. For your name, every knee shall bend, every tongue confess that you are true living God. No other God before you or after you, Master. Thank you, Jesus. You paid the ransom for each and every one of us, Father, with your stripes. We are already healed,
yes,
Master.
Father,
Thank you. Took them all on your back. Without shedding of blood, there is no remission for our sins,
yes.
Master. You shed your precious blood for each and every one of us. Thank you, Jesus.
Father.
Thank you, Abba Father. We glorify your name and we give you thanks for the life you've given us at this moment.
I
pray for the people who are praying, who is watching us right now. Father, open the blind eyes to see you, my Lord Jesus.
Master, yes.
Open the deaf ears to hear your word.
Oh, yes.
Open the heart to hear your word, Master. Ponder your word in the heart,
yes, thank you,
and the
Father.
Mind and soul.
Thank you,
Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father, all the blessing you're doing. And my brothers and sisters who are watching right now, wherever they are watching, whenever they are watching, we are praying for everyone, Father. Whatever sickness they are going through in the mind, in the body and soul, Father. Every sickness, Father, we rebuke it in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Father, away from
this,
your children, Master. Protect them. Father, without you, they can do nothing in this world, Father. Thank you, Abba, Father.
Thank you.
It was a wonderful day. Once again, I offer this day in your loving hand, Master. Pray for this network. I'll see you on our staff. Bless every one of them, Father. Bless all the world, what is going around the world, Father. Give them the peace that we need, Father. The world is full of evil and all the tragedies going around the world, Father. We pray for all the persecuted Christians around the world, Father.
Yes.
We pray for those families also at this moment. Father, pray for all the natural calamities. And Father, pray for all this going around, Father. Once again, we bring every petition to the throne room. We pray for all our brothers and sisters. Once again, who ask us to pray. We pray for everyone at this moment, dear God. Thank you, Abba Father. I pray for my brother as he's going to speak your word. You are in control, Master. Speak your word, Lord Jesus. And I ask all this in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise you. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Father God. Thank you. You're an awesome God. We love you, Lord. Thank you for blessing every dear one's here. And you know, today we're going to continue what I started last week and the day before, you know, a couple of weeks ago. It started about, you know, how we can really continue the miracles of Christ. You know, everything that Christ has ever done. For whatever he's commissioned his disciples, my dear brothers and sisters, it will continue. I mean, that is the greatest gift for the mankind. Christ came to this world 2,000 years ago, and he never disappeared. Yeah, but you don't see him. But, you know, he said, blessed are those who don't see and yet believe. So it is your belief and my belief is so very important at this moment, so we could able to feel his presence, because, you know, without the faith, remember, I always insist, without the faith, we cannot see him. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1 to 6, without the faith, we cannot see. At the same time, without holiness, we cannot see him either. Without the holiness, we cannot see him either. But how do you see him? Because you're seeking him diligently asking Him and seeking Him, and you will really find, my dear brothers and sisters. You know, He set up this beautiful church 2,000 years ago. It outlived everyone in the world. Every kingdom on this world, every empire's come and gone. Every leader's come and gone. Everything has just disappeared. But, you know, this name of this great God multiplies every day, my dear brothers and sisters, in your life and my life. So that's why, you know, as a family, we bring, like there was a real paralytic man. A man was paralytic, you know, St. Mark speaks about it. Four men together brought this man to Jesus Christ. They want to see what he's going to do. You know what he did? He was paralyzed for many, many years. These four men together, they just went, took a risk, and you know, they really wanted to bring the paralytic guy right before Jesus Christ, but they were not able to succeed because there was a huge crowd thronging to hear Jesus Christ. Just like today, there's such a huge followers all around the world. There's about 2.3 billion people. It's a vast, it's divine. For His kingdom, there is no end, my dear brothers and sisters, because they really saw the signs and wonders. So I'll let Sheila read. But that four men, you know what happened, you know, Mark chapter 2, you ought to read it. But I let Sheila read Mark chapter 16, verses 16 to 18. And you know, please, before that, my dear brothers and sisters, you know, when these guys, you know, took the paralytic up there, you know, they have no other room, they have no other way. So they have to risk in taking the paralytic man upon the roof, and they tried to unroof, willing to face any consequences. They let the man down wherever Christ was. And the next thing is, Jesus looking at their faith, those guys who really carrying the paralytic, and he said to that man, your sins are forgiven, just rise and walk. Rise and walk, because that is the power of the four, power of the prayer. So my dear sisters and other sisters here, we're all together, you know, invoking the presence of the Most High God, and I know that, you know, the same God, you know, who said rise and walk is still going to tell you whatever situation you guys are in, whatever problems you may be facing, whatever challenges. But today, in the holy name of Jesus Christ, my dear brothers, you know, this word is reverberating in your ears and my ears. So I let Sheila read Mark chapter 16. This is before Christ ascended to heaven. You know, he really, you know how he trained the disciples. He gave them the power to cast the demons, to heal the sick, and to announce the year of, the grace, the announce of jubilee for the mankind. And is that stopped? No, it never. That's why he assembled his 12 disciples, the elite chosen ones. And he really imparted the blessing before he was taken up to heaven. And he promised them he's going to send the Holy Ghost upon the church, upon the believers, and they will boldly proclaim the good news, not with just a word, my dear brothers and sisters, with the mighty powers, with the mighty signs and wonders. They will establish the kingdom of God. And I'll let Sheila read Mark chapter 16, verse 16 to 18. But I tell you, you know, all the blessing that's coming upon the apostles, the only requirement for you is you need to be a staunch follower of Christ. And you know, when you really need something, you will do anything. You know, here it comes freely. I'll let Sheila read that for you.
Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved, but whoever does not believe will be condemned. And these signs will accompany to those who believe in the name, and they will drive out demons. They will speak in new tongues. They will pick up snakes with their hands, and when they drink deadly poison, it will not hurt them at all. They will place their hands on sick people, and they will get well.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. My dear brothers and sisters, they will place their hands on the sick, and they will really drink the poison. It's not going to affect them. And the serpent power, you know, the serpent can attack them, but it is not, that venom is not going to kill them. The venom, that means, you know, Satan can attack you anywhere around. But the Lord is saying, you know, because you trust in the Lord, that venom cannot touch you. That poison cannot touch you, my dear brothers and sisters. That is the promise. If that really happened in the lives of the apostles, that's what we're going to see it today. You know, if that's really, it's going to happen, is it happening now? Is that a story? No, my dear brothers and sisters, you know, this is history's story. And Jesus Christ yesterday, come on guys.
Today,
and forever, He remains the same God. He gave that power. You gave the dynamis. That is awesome Holy Spirit that really works great signs and wonders. And it continues, my dear brothers and sisters, you like it or not. That's why, you know, when you believe in Christ, all this sign, you will speak in a new tongue. You'll speak, your language will be love language. You speak love to everyone. You won't carry that venom. You won't carry that vengeance. Or you will always be forgiving because, you know, the Spirit of the Lord is upon you and upon me. He makes you, everyone, a new creature. So you and I are the new creatures. So my dear brothers and sisters, you know, if you really hear to these words and, you know, if you believe, these things will continue. You know, last segment, I was talking about Peter. God was using mightily Peter and all the apostles. And, you know, we hear that, you know, these great men and women, the believers who have been saved, whoever heard the message of Jesus Christ in Acts chapter 2, verse 44 to 47, he was preaching so poignantly and vehemently after the anointing of the Holy Ghost. And, you know, people who heard, they saw the signs and wonders, and they saw the heaven has really come down, and they could see, my dear brothers and sisters, the miracles. And, you know, it is something they have never seen in their life, and they gave their heart to Christ. That's all it takes for you and me to give our hearts to Christ and let Him rule over us. Because He says, I give you the heart of compassion. I give you a meek heart. And I give you a heart of power. And He's going to impart His power upon you, my dear brothers and sisters. That's why, my dear brothers and sisters, you know, like here, the believers in Acts chapter 4, verse 29 and 30, 31, 32, if you read it, Acts chapter 4, and he's, you know, Peter stands up before all the crowd, and he says, you know, there is no other name among the mortals. Acts chapter 4, verse 12. There's only one name, the name that is above all the name, Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. There is no other name given among the mortals. So that means there's only one name that you and I will be saved from eternal damnation. God so loved the world, He gave His only begotten Son. Whoever believes in Him shall not perish. They will not. You know, that is the promise from Christ. And that is reverberating in your ears. It's echoing through this network, through me. He's using His disciples everywhere. They really take the gospel and spreading this gospel everywhere, my dear brothers and sisters. Good news, God, you know, God's good news. Gospel is God's good news, my dear brothers and sisters. So, you know, like I tell you, you know, what really happened, you know, when Peter stood there and, you know, like, great miracles started. And there was a lame man, as I told you last time, he started walking. And, you know, the price they have to pay is, you know, here in Acts chapter 5, verse 12, you know, they literally, because of the signs and the wonders, you know, the people in Israel, they couldn't handle it. The Romans cannot handle the Pharisees and the Sadducees. You know, the ruling body, they were not able to accept this challenge because they thought they crucified Christ, and now in his holy name, all this great and notable miracle, it says in Acts chapter 4, verse 16, a notable miracle that never happened, and they could see a lame man 40 years walking again. And the prize they received is they hushed, they warned them not to use his name. But, you know, none of these guys are going to stop. Nobody is going to stop. My dear brothers and sisters, whoever really experienced Christ, they will never stop until you receive the power of the Holy Spirit. Until you all receive the miracles and the signs, you know, nothing in the world is going to stop you, my dear brothers and sisters. No persecution, no sickness, no death, neither angels nor things present, things to show up. Sword, famine, whatever it is, you know, St. Paul says, nothing in the world will separate you from the love of Jesus Christ. So, dear brothers and sisters, you know, you need to really claim this great promise. You need to claim this great, great promise. You know, they're all together. You know, when they arrested the apostles, they put them all in the prison. You know, really what happened? In chapter 5, verse 12 to 16, if you read it, you know, Acts chapter 5, verse 12 to 16, and 17 and 18, you could see that God sent, these guys were all in prison. All the 12 disciples, and I don't know how many were there. They're taking the whole bunch of them and put them behind the bar. You know what happened? God sent a mighty angel. See, it never stopped. God sent a mighty angel, and the angel of God opened the door, opened the prison's door. So whatever door, you know, maybe you are confined in your own door. It may be a sickness, it may be an addiction, it may be somebody's curse upon you, or, you know, you inherited the curse. Whatever it is, you are in your own confined. You know, this is what happens. You know, the angel of God has been sent, and he will release you. That's what really happened. In Acts chapter 5, verse 12 to 18, you can see the angel of God opens a door. Next thing, they're proclaiming the gospel right in the before the temple. Oh, my dear brothers and sisters, nobody can stop the gospel. Nobody in the world, none of them, no ISIS, no leaders in the world, nobody in the world was ever born to oppose this gospel. It will pierce everybody's heart, my dear brothers and sisters. So I challenge you again. I really now I ask Sheila to read Acts chapter 13, verse 11. Here is Paul. Paul, you opposed Christ. He campaigned against the followers, and you know he became blind. And God sent an anointed man named Ananias. And he prayed over this man, and God did great things. He opened his blind eyes. In the chapter Acts chapter 9, you can read that. And he opened his eyes, and not only that, you know, here God filled him with the Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit come upon him. So you know, when he received the Holy Spirit, so my dear brothers and sisters, you know, look what really happened. You know, here he is really preaching the gospel in a place. Just watch, you know, here it is. Just Sheila, I let Sheila read it in Acts chapter 13, verse, 11, please.
Now the hand of the Lord is against you. You're going to be blind for a time, not even able to see the light of the sun. Immediately the mist and the darkness came over him, and he groped about seeking someone to lead him by the hand. When the proconsul saw what had happened, he believed, for he was amazed.
Hallelujah.
Teaching about the Lord.
Hallelujah. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, here's the man who opposed Christ. The man who opposed the followers of Christ. Now he could able to proclaim the power of Christ, that nothing in the world could stop him. And with signs and wonders, here it is,
yes.
A false prophet, you know, a sorcerer, a diviner was trying to stop Paul. He couldn't.
It couldn't work. His magic skill, his witchcraft against Paul never worked. Paul looked at them and he said, you know, you'll be blind because you rejected the sun, you will be eclipsed from the sun. You rejected the Son of God, and you will be eclipsed from the sun. You can't see anymore. He was blinded them, my dear brothers and sisters. He halted the guy. So, you know, it says the people started believing in Christ. Not only that, you know, in Acts chapter 19, verse 12 onwards, if you read it, to 12 to 19, great signs followed. Great signs and wonders followed through the apostles, especially Peter and John and James. And here is Paul. You know, even the handkerchief, whatever touched his body, you know, the demons can't handle it. People demon-possessed were, you know, cast away. They were really, they can't handle the handkerchief of St. Paul. My dear brothers and sisters, they see a mighty revival and the healing breaks out. And now, you know, somebody was using the name of Jesus. I let Sheila read verse 19, chapter 9, Acts chapter 19, verse 19. Here, you know, amazing, amazing. People hear the gospel and they see the healing freely flows to people. And those sorcerers, those diviners, those charmers, those superstitious people who believe and they spend tons of money. And now look at what happened because they saw, you know, the demon possessed demons are coming out, freaking out. You can read that, my dear brothers and sisters. They cannot use the name of Jesus unless they've been anointed by the power of the Holy Ghost. And here I let Sheila read Acts chapter 19, verse 19. Look what happened in the whole city. They bring all this charm. Just can you read, Sheila, please?
A number who had practiced sorcery brought their scrolls together and burned them publicly. When they calculated the value of the scrolls, the total came to 50,000 drachmas.
Hallelujah. Can you imagine 50,000 worth of silver coin? You know, this is about all these nuances. It's about the charming. It's about all the divinations and sorcery. And by the brothers and sisters, all the paraphernalia, you know, the people believe, even in the United States, in the world, people believe in all this. They spend a lot of tons of money. It is all from the paraphernalia, my dear brothers and sisters. Here that nothing worked for anybody. People are not healed. People are not saved.
Yes.
People have never seen any revival.
Yes.
They never seen the renewal or the transformation in their life. But here, Paul's preaching about Jesus Christ brought such a great transformation in the entire city of Ephesus. You have to read it to believe, my dear brothers and sisters. Please read it, Acts chapter 19, verses from 1 to 19. If you read it, you will know the power. It'll never die. The power of Christ will never die.
Yes.
He resurrected, my dear brothers and sisters. That's what you're seeing it. Whenever you see a miracle, Christ is on the throne.
Yes.
And your crisis can't present when you see Christ upon the throne. You need to see him bigger than your problem, bigger than your sickness, bigger than your death, whatever situation it is, bigger than the doctor's report.
Yes.
See him big and everything will vanish away from you and I, my dear brothers and sisters. You know, I'll continue this, the next segment. You know, my dear brothers and sisters, it's an awesome time that we're living in to really experience the scintillating power of the Most High God. He is demonstrating, you know, through signs and wonders, you know, not just the word. You know, if you believe this word, all things are possible. Can you say that word?
All things are possible
to those who believe in Jesus Christ. So, my dear brothers and sisters, his name will multiply. It will continue forever and forever. And you know what? He is your Lord and your Savior. He is your principes, the mighty God and a great Lord. And you know, open your hearts. Open your heart. Receive him.
Yes.
Let him be the king of your family. Let him be the personal Lord of your family.
Yes, yes.
You know, you need to live with them, Master, my brothers and sisters. You have to really come together, intertwine together, inseparable. And you will see great signs and wonders will follow your life and all the people that have been struggling with you, praying for, and they will see amazing glory of Christ. So I let Sheila talk to you finally and bring you great final doxology.
My dear ones, you heard an awesome message today. Continue your prayer request and praise report. And don't forget to send your love offering or donation to our ministry, as we have to take the gospel to the world. And please support us and stand by us. And
we are all praying for you.
And we heard a lot of praise report. We praise you and glorify the Lord's name, as so many miracles and healing is happening. So please don't forget to send your love offering and donation to our ministry. And we'll see you next segment. And God bless you all and love you all.
Bye-bye. God bless.